afternoon to all of you. Welcome you all for this celebration. We offer this Mass for the Diocese of Guntur, Narasrapet Parish. This Mass is offered for Divya Vani TV, Corpus Fund, donors Sri Nagothu Shavraya, Srimati Josephine on the 47th wedding anniversary, for good health of all family members, thanking God for all the graces received by Srimati Chinnamma, Dr. Rajit Kumar, Dr. Lakshmi Saroja, Kranti Kumar, Radhika, Srinivasa Rao, Radhika, Rohit, Pujita Adenia, Bhavana, Shavriya, Rohan, Anvit and family members. Today's Rosary, Divine Mercy Chaplet, Word of God, Holy Hour are also offered for this family and their intentions. Today the Church is remembering a great saint called St. Ignatius of Loyola, the founder of the congregation called the Society of Jesus, to which I also belonged, known as Jesuits. Our Holy Father also belonged to the same congregation. Till now, these Jesuits who existed for more than 500 years are known for their education all over the world. But this year, from last year, October onwards, slowly the world over, people come to know about Jesuits because of Father Stan Swami, who died on the 5th of July 2021. A man who worked among the Adivasis, the marginalized. 84-year-old man was kept in prison for 10 years, 10 months. And now his ash is being taken around to many places. As we think of this man, I want to pray for one grace, for me at least, to imbibe at least 5% of the qualities of this man first transforming. Can you open my voice for the voiceless? At least let there be 10 more Stan Swamis who can stand with the poor and the marginalized and fight for their justice, whatever be the cause, keeping Jesus as the model. So ask God's pardon for the moments wherein I was silent spectator. Ask God's pardon and courage also to imbibe the qualities of this great man, Jesuit, Father Stan Swami. I confess
to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts, in my words, in what I have done, and in what I have failed to do, through my fault, through my most grievous fault. Therefore I ask the Blessed Mary, our Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on all of us, forgive us all our sins, sins of commission and sins of omission, and bring us all to life and grace everlasting.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Let us pray. O God, who raised up Saint Ignatius of Loyola in your church to further the greater glory of your name, grant that by his help we may imitate him in fighting the good fight on earth and merit to receive with him a crown in heaven. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you, the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
Amen. A reading from the book of Leviticus, chapter 25, verses 1 and 8 to 17. A reading from the book of Leviticus, chapter 25, verses 1 and 8 to 17. The Lord said to Moses on Mount Sinai, You shall count 7 weeks of years, 7 times 7 years, so that the time of the 7 weeks of years shall be to you 49 years. Then you shall send abroad the loud trumpet on the 10th day of the 7th month. On the day of atonement you shall send abroad the trumpet throughout all your land. And you shall hallow the 50th year and proclaim liberty throughout the land of all his inheritance. It shall be a jubilee for you when each of you shall return to his property and each of you shall return to his family. A jubilee shall that 50th year be to you. In it you shall neither sow nor reap with what grows of itself, nor gather the grapes from the undressed vines. For it is a jubilee, it shall be holy to you. You shall eat what is yields out of the field. In this year of jubilee, each of you shall return to his property. And if you sell to your neighbor or buy from your neighbor, you shall not wrong one another, according to the number of years after the jubilee. You shall buy from your neighbor, and according to the number of years for crops, he shall sell to you. If the years are many, you shall increase the price. And if the years are few, you shall diminish the price. For it is the number of the crops that he is selling to you. You shall not wrong one another, but you shall fear your God, for I am the Lord your God. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Your response shall be, let the peoples praise you, O God.
Let the peoples praise you, O Lord.
Let all the peoples praise you.
Let all the peoples praise you.
O God, be gracious and bless us. Let your face shed its light upon us. So will your ways be known upon earth, and all nations learn your saving help. Your response, let the peoples praise you, O God.
Let the peoples praise you, O God.
Let all the peoples praise you.
Let all the peoples praise you.
Let the nations be glad and exult. For you rule the world with justice. With fairness you rule the peoples. You guide the nations on earth. Your response, let the peoples praise you, O God.
Let the peoples praise you, O God.
Let all the peoples praise you.
Let all the peoples praise you.
The earth has yielded its fruit, for God, O God, has blessed us. May God still give us his blessing, till the ends of the earth revere him. Your response, let the peoples praise you, O God.
Let the peoples praise you, O God.
Let all the peoples praise you.
Let all the peoples praise you. A man loves me, he will keep my word, and my Father will love him, and we will come to him. With you
and with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Saint Matthew.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Chapter 14, verses 1 to 12. Herod the tetrarch heard about the fame of Jesus, and he said to his servants, "This is John the Baptist. He has been raised from the dead. That is why these powers are at work in him." For Herod had seized John and bound him and put him in prison for the sake of Herodias, his brother Philip's wife, because John said to him, "It is not lawful for you to have her." And though he wanted to put him to death, he feared the people because they held him to be a prophet. But when Herod's birthday came, the daughter of Herodias danced before the company and pleased Herod, so that he promised with an oath to give her whatever she might ask. Whatever she might ask. Prompted by her mother, she said, "Give me the head of John the Baptist here on a platter." And the king was sorry. But because of his oaths and his guests, he commanded it to be given. He sent and had John beheaded in the prison. And his head was brought on a platter and given to the girl, and she brought it to her mother. And his disciples came and took the body and buried it. And they went and told Jesus. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Dear brothers and sisters in Christ Jesus, here we see the great King Herod. In spite of all his capacity, he is not able to recognize Jesus, who's performing so many miracles. He mistakes him for John the Baptist. As even the devils are able to recognize Jesus. Have you come here, Lord Jesus, to torment us? Whereas this great man, King, is not able to identify it was Jesus. Why? Why? This man had killed John the Baptist because he was leading a very wrong life there, and has beheaded him. Therefore, he has created a lot of guilt feeling in him. Guilt feeling. Because of that, he is not able to recognize a man called Jesus. See, one after the other sins. The guilt feeling. My friends, if we examine our own life, there are 13 differences between religiosity and spirituality. 13 differences between religiosity and spirituality. One great difference is any religion creates a guilt feeling in the people. Your mother went to some Hindu temple 10 years back. That is why now you are suffering. You made a promise to go to Valankanni. You didn't fulfill your promise. That's why your husband is suffering so much. Like this, many, many religions are creating guilty feeling in us. That's what religions do. Whereas, if I bother about spirituality, it removes the guilty feeling. Therefore, I have made a mistake. But from here, where do I go? Can I learn a lesson from my mistake? That's what spirituality does. And this is what Jesus went about doing. He removes the guilty feeling from the people. Say, for example, the woman caught in adultery. She has such a low self-esteem. I escaped all these years. Now today I was caught red-handed. So all the Pharisees who caught her in the very act of adultery are trying to condemn her. And here is a man called Jesus. He says, "Neither do I condemn you." He removes a guilty feeling from her, and thus she becomes a great follower of Jesus. Today, I try to enjoy the freedom given to us by Jesus Christ, who is following spirituality, not religiosity, who tries to remove the guilty feeling from us. Next, we know the whole story, how John the Baptist was beheaded because he told Herod, it is not lawful for you. It is not lawful for you to live with your brother's wife. And now, you know, he is beheaded. I was saying the same story to 10 people. Just see who is responsible for the death of John the Baptist. Their answers will be different. 10 people will give different answers. Some may say Herod, some say Herodias, some may say Philip, the brother of Herod. Like there's so many people. There was a woodcutter staying very close to a big forest. He used to cut the firewood. He was living with his wife, but his pucker drunkard every day used to beat his wife, a very beautiful wife. She used to collect the firewood every day, what the husband is cutting, and she used to go in a boat crossing the small river, the other side, to sell it to a merchant. And with that money, she used to buy vegetables, meat, and so on to the house, comes back. It was going on for many, many months and years. One day, the husband had beaten her very badly. Meantime, she has developed some kind of friendship with that owner of the shop. She said, "Let me not live with this man. That man is ready to accept me. Let me go and stay with him, live with him, instead of staying here and dying every day." So night was night. Husband has beaten her very, very badly. And the husband is sleeping. She went to the river, woke up the boatman to cross the river. He said, "Not now, I can't come." The man refused. Then she didn't want to come back home. She said, "If I walk a little more, there is a bridge. I cross the bridge and go to the other side. At the same time, I know plenty of wild animals are there." She says, "I have great faith in God, faith in Anthony," and so on. So he goes there. Next day morning, the news comes to paper. She was killed by some wild animals. Now, pause for a while and see who is responsible for the lady's death. Husband, or she herself, or the boatman, anybody else, or that man, the house shop owner, anybody else? Yeah, somebody says it is the forest people in charge of the forest. Yes, different people are responsible, differing upon my perception. Similarly, for the death of Herod, different perspectives are there. Depending upon my perspective, I can say Herod is responsible. Some will say Herodias is responsible. Some will say Philip, he should have been very happy with this lady there. She should have been a little more strict with this lady so that she may not go and stay with his own brother. Some may say even John the Baptist. This man should have been a little more prudent. Like for Stan Swami, some people say he should have been prudent not to fight against this government. So, similarly nowadays we come across so many people there. "Father, my wife ran away with father, left me alone, father. Who's responsible?" Yes, check and see. He's putting whole blame on the wife there. Can I be also responsible? Maybe I didn't understand her properly. Some say, "Father, my child is not studying well at all, father. From 8th standard onwards, she is losing rank, father. Maybe she is busy with her cell phone, father." No, maybe the father started drinking more, having extramarital affair. So different people are involved. Different people are involved in this kind of problems. So who is responsible? Instead of putting blame on others, can I be humble enough to accept my own responsibility? I too may be a part of this problem. I too may be a part of this problem. Instead of blaming this government, that government, can I accept my own responsibility? Next, coming to the life of St. Ignatius, great man. Slowly pause for a while and see how the conversion is taking place in the life of St. Ignatius. He's an ordinary man, longing for fame and name in the society. He was daydreaming about noble lady, army man. There was a 20th of May 1521, just 500 years ago, there was a battle between France and Spain. He's a Spaniard. In that battle, a cannonball struck him and one leg was broken, another leg was very badly damaged. So he was trying to take rest there, people are trying to treat him, and as usual he wants to read the novel, but they did not give him novel, they gave him only a life of saints and imitation of Christ. And he was not interested at all in that because he was a worldly man, full of worldly pleasure. Some slowly started reading the life of saints. And he was inspired by the life of this, some of the saints. Then he says, if he and she could do, why not I, my dear friends? That was a turning point in his life. Earlier looking into himself, now slowly is able to look outside, outside, outside. When he and she could do so much for others, why not I do? That was a turning point in his life. This is a spirituality of Jesus. The spirituality of Jesus. What is that? Jesus always asks us to look outside. Look at the lilies. Look at the flowers. Look at the birds of the air. Look at the man standing in front and praying. Look at another man standing back and praying. Look at the lady putting so much of coin there. He's asking us to look outside, outside, outside. This is the spirituality of Jesus. How spirituality is, look into myself there. Go deep into yourself. Feel sorry for your sins there. Accept all your sins. Go for confession. Look into yourself. Nothing is going to happen. Nothing is going to happen. So take some of the people in the New Testament particularly who are converted. Say for example, St. Paul was converted. Everybody knows about his conversion. Why? Did he go for retreat? Did he have 1 month retreat by Jesuits? A sudden change in him. 1 second. Suddenly he goes on a horse. He sees a huge bright light during the daylight. Broad daylight. Same night, a small bulb somewhere burning, I can see. But broad daylight, he sees another very big bright light. That was the moment of his conversion. Prodigal son. He went away from the father. Why is he coming back to the father? Is he feeling sorry for his sins? Did he go for any confession? Did he take any resolution? Hereafter, I'll never commit the same sin once more. And from there, he's able to see the greatness of his father. And in my father's house, even the hired servants, the two kinds of servants, one is permanent, another one is temporary. Even the hired servants have enough and more to eat. What a great father I have got. The moment he's able to look at the father's greatness, look outside, his life is completely changed. A Samaritan woman drawing water in the well. Jesus talks to her slowly about the water, life-giving water. What is happening there? Suddenly he says, Arede, this man knows about my past life. I never told you how many husbands I've got, but this man knows about my past life. Could he be the Messiah? That was a turning point in her life, and she becomes an evangelizer. Yes, my dear brothers and sisters, today as we think of the feast of St. Ignatius of Loyola, let's try to learn this spirituality. Learn to look outside. Not myself, my problem, my family, my religion, my resolutions there, my mass, my rosary. No, go beyond, beyond, beyond myself. Look outside. You know the famous saying, I was crying for shoes till I saw a man without legs. I was crying for shoes because I was thinking only about myself. But that fellow doesn't have even legs, man. How much more I should be grateful to God. In spite of all this corona, etc., still I am alive, you are alive. Otherwise, you won't be here at all. Therefore, today, during this mass, let us pray for this grace, single grace, to go beyond myself. Out of myself, to look outside so that I may really surrender myself to God and just accept Him as my personal Savior and thus build His kingdom. May St. Ignatius pray for us. Let's praise forth all our petitions to God our Father, who's really merciful, who's teaching us how to pray, where to look at. Let's pray for Pope Francis, a Jesuit, who's leading all of us in the right direction these days, a very challenging person. Let's pray that God's grace be with him and he may be a good shepherd to all of us. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Let's pray mainly for the Jesuits all over the world, that they may imbibe the qualities of Jesus Christ, may imbibe some of the qualities of the revolutionary people like Stan Swami, etc., so that they may give life to many more marginalized, the suffering, the abandoned people. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Let's pray for our diocese, archdiocese, our bishop, archbishop, and other bishops, the priests, that we may really be open enough to accept God's grace in our lives and thus be a role model to many more people. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Let's pray for the donors, that they may also enjoy God's presence with them. Let's pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Abba, Father, thank and praise you for being our Father every moment of our life. Thank and praise you for opening our eyes to look outside of ourselves so that we may see your greatness and experience your power every moment, and thus we may surrender ourselves to you and to the people. We may this prayer, Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Sacrifice we offer may be pleasing to God Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at our hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and good of all his holy church.
May these offerings we make to you as we celebrate St. Ignatius be pleasing, Lord God, and grant that the sacred mysteries which you have made the fount of all holiness may sanctify us too in the truth. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord is with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord living God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For in the saints who consecrated themselves to Christ, for the sake of the kingdom of heaven, it is right to celebrate the wonders of your providence, by which you call human nature back to its original holiness and bring it to experience on this earth the gifts you promise in the new world to come. And so with all the angels and saints, with our suffering people around us who are the prisons without any fault of their own, we too proclaim your glory as we say. Source of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dew fall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more, "Father, giving you thanks and praise, he gave it to his disciples, saying, 'Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me.'" The mystery of faith.
You have saved us free.
Thank you, Father, for setting us free. Thank you, Jesus, for setting us free. Free to understand others, free to forgive others, free to give life to others, free enough to visit somebody who is really sick, free to open my voice and speak for the voiceless. Thank you, Father, for setting us all free. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his life, death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you and to the needy around us. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Lord God, remember your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope, Pula Antony Archbishop, and all the bishops, the clergy, the religious, the laity everywhere. Remember also our sisters and brothers who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy, welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, Blessed Apostles, and all the saints, Saint Ignatius of Loyola, who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be coerced to eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord and our Savior. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours. All glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
Calling God as our Father, who is revealing his power to us every moment. Let us say the prayer Jesus Christ taught us meaningfully. Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name.
Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. The evil of not opening our eyes to see your greatness around us. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my own peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church and our own faith, and graciously grant us peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
May the peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other a sign of peace.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Grant us your peace.
May the receiving of your body and blood, Lord Jesus Christ, not bring us to judgment and condemnation, but through your loving mercy be for us protection in mind and body and a healing remedy. Behold our Lord Jesus Christ, who goes about removing the guilty feeling from us, setting us all free to set many more people free. Happy we are called to this banquet.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
May this body and blood of Jesus Christ be a life and happiness everlasting.
Amen. Prayer of Spiritual Communion. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come into my heart spiritually. I embrace you as if you were already there and unite myself to you wholly. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
Saint Ignatius, we thank and praise you for your courage to lead many, many people through your spiritual exercises, AMDG, all for the greater glory of God. Help us to give glory to God, recognizing His greatness, not giving glory to our own selves. Saint Ignatius, pray for us. Saint Ignatius, pray for us. Saint Ignatius, pray for us. Let us pray. May the sacrifice of praise that we have offered with thanksgiving in honor of Saint Ignatius, O Lord, bring us to exalt your majesty without end through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Prayer to Saint Joseph. Hail, guardian of the Redeemer, spouse of the Blessed Virgin Mary, to you God entrusted his only Son. In you, Mary placed her trust. With you, Christ became man. Blessed Joseph, to us too, show yourself a father and guide us in the path of life. Obtain for us grace, mercy, and courage, and defend us from every evil. Amen.
Amen.
The Lord is with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless us, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Let's go in peace to give glory to God our Father.
Thanks be to God.
Amazing grace, how sweet. I once was lost, but
days